Welcome to Grab & Go Info. Databricks Widget API enables users to apply different parameters for notebooks and dashboards. It's best for rerunning the same code using different parameter values. When used in dashboards, it creates filters for the dashboard charts. Databricks supports both Python and SQL code for the Widget API. In this tutorial, we will talk about how to create widgets using Python. We will cover how to create different types of widgets using Python, how to retrieve widgets values, how to pass the widget values to notebooks and dashboards, how to configure the widget setup, how to delete widgets. To learn about SQL widgets, please refer to my tutorial Databricks Widgets in SQL Notebook. Let's get started. There are four types of Databricks widgets. Text takes text as inputs. Dropdown creates a dropdown list with values. Combo box is a combination of text and dropdown. Users can either select values from the dropdown list or input their own values. Multiselect creates a list of values. Users can select one or more values from the list. To get the help information about widgets, use dbutils.widgets.help. The output has the methods available for widgets and their syntax. To get the help information about a specific widget method, use dbutils.widgets.help method name. For example, I can use dbutils.widgets.help combo box to get information about the combo box method. In the first step, we will import the PySpark SQL functions for data processing. The timestamp is for processing time data. When is for creating new columns based on conditions. And call is for working with columns. In step 2, a CSV dataset on cryptocurrency prices is read from a mounted S3 bucket. The dataset is a subset of the Kaggle G Research Crypto Forecasting dataset. To learn how to mount an AWS S3 bucket to Databricks, please refer to my previous tutorial Databricks Mount to AWS S3 and Import Data. After reading the data, we will do some data processing. The timestamp is in Unix epoch format, which is the number of seconds since January 1st of 1970 Coordinated Universal Time. Using the timestamp, we changed it to a date-time format. The columns that are not used in the visualization are dropped. We also created a new column for asset names. In step 3, we use Python to create different types of Databricks widgets. The dropdown widget is for the asset name column. It has the name of dropdown filter and the default value of Bitcoin. There are four choices in the dropdown: Bitcoin, Ethereum, Other, and All. All means selecting all the asset names. The multiselect widget is based on the asset name column. It has the name of multiselect filter and the default value of Bitcoin. The three choices, Bitcoin, Ethereum, and Other, are the three unique values for the asset name column. We can select multi-values using the multiselect widget. The combo box widget is based on the asset ID column. It has the name of combo box filter and the default value of 0. The unique values of the asset ID column is pulled using the distinct function. The text widget is based on the asset ID column too. It has the name of text filter and the default value of 0. Users can enter the asset ID into the box. After creating the widgets, in step 4, we will check the value of each widget. A widget value can be retrieved by passing the widget name into dbutils.widgets.get. We save the retrieved widget values into variables and printed it out. In step 5, we will talk about how to pass the widget values using Python. We can use dbutils.widgets.get function to pull the value directly from the widget like the code below. Or alternatively, we can pass the value using the variable created in step 4. In this example, we take the variable called multiselectFilterValue, split the string using comma as the delimiter, and filter the data frame by checking if the asset name is in the multiselectFilter list. When the dropdown widget has all as an option, we need to treat all and other options differently because all is not a value in the data frame column. One way to do this is to use if-else conditions to display all records if the dropdown widget value is all, and filter by the widget value otherwise. If you have made it this far, you probably find the information in this tutorial helpful. Please click the like button and subscribe to the channel. Tell me what tutorial you would like me to create in the comments. The next video may be based on your request. In Step 6, we will talk about how to use widgets as filters for Databricks dashboard. Firstly, let's create a time series chart for volume using Databricks' built-in tool. Click the downward triangle next to the bar chart icon. Then select the line chart option. Next, click the plot options icon to check if the settings for the chart are correct and make changes if necessary. To create a dashboard, click the bar chart icon on the upper right corner of the cell. Then click Add to New Dashboard. This opens the dashboard. We can see the filters on the top of the dashboard. To learn more about how to create a Databricks dashboard, please refer to my tutorial Databricks Dashboard for Big Data. In Step 7, we will configure the Databricks widget by clicking the gear icon on the top right of the notebook. The widget's panel settings window will pop up. Under On Widget Change, there are three options. Run access commands means that when the widget values change, only the cells that directly retrieve the changed widget are rerun. This is the default setting, but it does not work for SQL cells. Do nothing means that the notebook will not rerun based on the new widget values. Run notebook means rerun the whole notebook. I recommend choosing this option to prevent missing some of the important steps in the code. The widgets panel is pinned to the top of the notebook by default, but we can uncheck the pinned to top option to show it above the first cell. Sometimes we may need to run the notebook with specific parameters from another notebook. In that case, we can use %run to run the notebook and pass the parameters at the same time. The sample code below is from the Databricks documentation for widgets. In Step 9, we will talk about how to delete Databricks widgets. To delete one widget, use dbutils widgets remove widget name. To remove all widgets, use dbutils widgets remove all. After removing a widget, we cannot create new widgets in the same cell. New widgets need to be created in a separate cell. In this tutorial, we talked about how to create widgets using Python. You learned how to create different types of widgets using Python, how to retrieve widgets' values, how to pass the widget values to notebooks and dashboards, how to configure the widget setup, how to delete widgets. Note that you cannot use widgets to pass arguments between different languages within a notebook and run it in a scheduled job. So when the widgets are created in Python, the value of the widgets need to be retrieved by Python as well. To learn about how to run Databricks jobs, please refer to my tutorial Databricks Multitask Job Scheduling. If you prefer the written version of the tutorial, please go to grabandgoinfo.com. I will put the link in the video description. This is the blog post for this tutorial. It has all the screenshots and explanations in the video. To learn more about Databricks, please subscribe to the channel and check out my YouTube playlist for Databricks. Click the playlist on the screen now. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.